Hi my dear kids, welcome back to our today's mathematics class. In the previous class, we learned how to draw a dodecagon by using this corner of a set square. Today also, we are going to continue the activity. Dividing circles into different parts and drawing polygons inside the circle. Look at this activity. Draw a circle with diameter 6 cm. Divide the circle into 4 equal parts. Join the ends of these diameters. What shape do we get? At first, we have to find the radius of this circle. We know that diameter equals 6 cm. The formula to find the radius equals diameter divided by 2. That is 6 cm divided by 2 equals 3 cm. Radius equals 3 cm. So children, at first we have to draw a circle of radius 3 cm. Take measure 3 cm in a compass. By using this radius, we have to draw a circle. Mark its center. Then draw its diameter by using a ruler. We know that diameter is the longest line which passes through the center of the circle. Next, we have to take set square number 1. To draw this figure, we have to use its square corner. Place the square corner at the center. Then mark a point upright on the circle. Next, we have to turn the position of said square like this. The square corner of the said square should meet the center. Then mark a point downward on the circle. Next, join these two points by using a ruler. This is the longest line which passes through the center of the circle. Now, we divide the circle into 4 equal parts. Then let's join these nearby points. Join these two points. Join the next two points. Join the next two points. Then join these two points also. See, when we divide a circle into 4 equal parts, we will get the figure square. Children, did you understand this? Let's move to another activity. See this activity? Using different corners of said square, draw other shapes. What shape do we get here by joining the points? How many sides does it have? At first, we have to draw a circle. Here, take the measure 4 cm in a compass. Then draw a circle of radius 4 cm. Then mark its center. Take set square number 1. This set square has two slanting corners. We have to use one of these corners to draw this figure. Place the slanting corner of the set square at the center of the circle. Then mark the points where the two edges of the set square meet the points on the circle. Then place the set square on this point. The corner of the set square meets the center. Then mark the point on the circle. Continue the process. Then place the set square on this point. Then mark a point on the circle. Then place the set square on this point. The corner of the set square should meet the center. Then mark a point on the circle. Then place the set square on this point. The corner of the set square should be at the same position. Then mark a point on the circle. At last, place the set square like this. Then mark a point on the circle. We mark all the points. Let's count the number of points on the circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Next, join all these nearby points. Draw a line to join these two points. Join these two points by using the ruler. Join the next two points. Join these two points by drawing a line. Join the next two points. Join these two points. Join the next two points. Finally, we have to join these two points also. Children, the shape is completed. Let's count its number of sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. This is a 8-sided polygon. So, the name of this shape is octagon. Children, did you understand? Children, there is an exercise for you. You have to do this in your maths note. Today's class is over. Thank you.